What is it?
This, Jen, is the internet.
What?
That's right.
This is the internet. The whole internet.
Yep. I offer a loan of it so that you could use it in your speech.
It's so small.
That's one of the surprising things about it.
Hang on. It doesn't have any wires or anything.
It's wireless.
Oh, yes, everything's wireless nowadays, isn't it? So I can really use it in my speech. What if someone needs it?
Oh, no, no. People will still be able to go online and everything. It'll still work.
Oh, good.
I tell you, you present this to the shareholders and you will get quite the response.
Mm. Can I touch it? It's so light.
Of course it is, Jen. The internet doesn't weigh anything.
No, of course it doesn't.
Hey! What is Jen doing with the internet?
Ma said I could use it for my speech.
Are you insane? What if she drops it?
I won't drop it. I'll look after it.
No, 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 Jen. No, this needs to go straight back to Big Ben.
Big Ben?
Yeah, it goes on top of Big Ben. That's where you get the best reception.
All right, I promise. I won't let anything happen to it.
No, Jen, I'm sorry. But the elders of the internet would never stand for
it. No, Roy, I spoke to the elders of the internet not 1 hour ago. I told them about Jen winning Employee of the Month, and they were so impressed that they wanted to do whatever they could to help.
Wait a minute. The elders of the internet. The elders of the internet know who I am. You've got to let me have it.
No, Jen, I'm sorry. It's just too risky.
Oh, please, Roy. Oh.
Well, Mars, has it been completely demagnetized?
By Stephen Hawking himself. Who sends his congratulations, by the way.
Well, if it's okay with the hawk.
So, can I have it?
You can.
Oh, don't forget your speech.
Oh, thank you.
Shh.
Hey, everyone, guys. Morning, welcome back to Datacom Lecture. So today we are in week 3, lecture 2. And yeah, what you have just saw is actually one of your ex-CN students who didn't pay attention in the Datacom class. Okay, so you don't want to be like that. There is second part to the video that I'll be showing you later if you have time. Okay, where she actually made her speech about the internet. Okay, but if that is true, then this class is going to be very, very short lah. It's like, okay, that's it class. Thank you for coming today. So yeah, let's talk about what we want to do today. We will go through three kinds of networking devices. So we will have, I'll show you a hub, a switch and a router, and then we want to compare how they are different from each other and when we should be using a switch or a hub or a router when we are building a network. So the whole point of this lecture is we are going to build our first local area network. So all the while as of right now, you and me, we are just the user of the internet. So we pay TM for some money, okay, a lot of money actually, and then they provide us with the internet connections. They come and set up all the whatever thing that has to be set up so that we can get onto the internet. So today we want to do it differently. So from the other way around, we go behind the scene and then we want to build our own network, which means that today is also going to be the first day we want to start the try hack me. Okay, so yeah, if you didn't get it, it's okay. Maybe you are just not from UK. Only you are not banana enough, so you don't get it. So anyway, we will start with the concept of router, switch, and hub first. Okay, now we don't have slides for this, so I will just demonstrate the idea of why we have a few different kind of devices instead of why not we just use one device and then that device just do everything for us. So yeah. Right now, based on this diagram, we have to know the difference between a hub, a switch, and a router. Okay, now actually, in fact, you have a slide on that, but it's just really briefly telling you that we have these kind of devices, and today we want to know why we have like so many of them. Okay, so what you're seeing here right now is, I hope you're ready. I know it's early in the morning. So yeah, we have 8 PCs here, okay? When we talk about LAN, and LAN normally is, as you already know, it's called local area network. So you are in your own LAN, I'm in my own LAN. And in fact, there are so many LAN on the internet these days. And when you connect all these LANs together, it becomes the internet. So we have this concept called a LAN boundaries. For example, now even if you are living side by side, just next to your neighbor, correct? Like maybe just not even 100 meters away, but your neighbor is on their own LAN. You are on your own LAN, although physically you're really, really close to each other. So how do we know, like, okay, am I in LAN 1 or am I in LAN 2? And which LAN are you in? All right, so this one, it goes back to the LAN boundaries. So we have this thing called a LAN boundaries. Just like now, we also have boundaries for states. So if you drive from Gampa right now to, I don't know, Ipoh, then you have to be really rich because then you have to pay 1,000, I think. Yeah, you have LAN between districts. You also have you have boundary between districts, you have boundaries between cities, you have boundaries between states. So you have all these boundaries just as you see in a real map. So for network, it's also like that. Sometimes you have, this is a LAN, or this can be a LAN, or this can be a LAN, or this one is in its own LAN. So how do we know? It really depends on, of course, the hardware that we will be using. So again, we have three types of hardware. I'll just write them down so that you can refer back to them. Now, of course, this is a very, very generic representation. Like, I'm generalizing this. As like, for example, if you talk about routers, there are so many kinds of different routers that you can get. There are so many kinds of switch. Like, you have L1 switch, L2 switch, L3 switch, managed switch, and some other switch, okay? So in this example, we just use the simplest, most generic example, okay? So we have three different network devices here, hub, switch, and router. Now, depending on which device you use to connect all these PC together, you are going to get different kind of LAN later on. Okay, so let's start with hub first. Now, this is a hub. So today we will be doing this unboxing of the hub here. Yeah, just give me a minute. Just let me move the camera a bit. Oh, I think it's a bit hard. Why not I just show you the whole concept? Okay, let me just draw everything here. So once you get the idea, then only we see the real stuff, okay? Okay, now hub is if you compare among three of them, hub is the cheapest one. Okay, then switch is the at the same level, the same kind of spec, switch is the level 2, is actually much a bit more expensive than a hub. And then router is layer 3. So router is actually the most expensive among all these three devices. Okay, now all of them do the same thing actually. In fact, almost the same, not exactly the same. So they are used to connect and device together to form a network. But when you connect them, they give you different kind of network. So let's talk about hub. When I draw hub, I will just draw in this way, okay? A square, and then this square, H, means it's a hub. This one means a switch. This one means this is a router, okay? So this is a router, this is a switch, and this is a hub, okay? Now, right now, let's say I connect. Okay, my job right now is connect PC1, PC2, PC3, and PC4 all together to build network. So if I take a hub here, I put a hub here, then I take LAN cable, all the cable is the same, only the network device are different. Then I connect them together. Okay, now if I do this, don't look at the right side, just look at PC1, 2, 3, 4 only right now. So if I do this, this whole thing now become a LAN. This whole thing is a LAN. Okay, so hub is very simple. It's the simplest one. Means that once you connect device together to a same hub, all of them will join a same LAN. Alright? Now, it doesn't matter how many more I add. Let's say I add PCX or PCY or something else. Okay? They are all still going to belong to the same LAN because they are connected physically to the same hub. Alright? So, the same idea here, but this time I replace, instead of using a hub, I use a switch to connect them. So, same thing. I buy a switch, I pull the cable, put inside the cable, connect them together. Now, in this setup, when I'm connecting N devices together to a switch, they also form a LAN. So, this one also become a LAN. One single physical LAN. Okay, similar to a hub. Let's say right now I connect a few more PC here. They are all still going to be in the same LAN, alright? Which means that a hub or a switch, they doesn't matter how many devices you connect them to, as long as you have enough ports to put a cable in, they will give you one physical LAN. Alright? Now, if you're okay, then let's look at how what happened when I do this using a router. So the last and the most expensive device that we have seen is a router. And now I do the same. Physically, I do the same. I connect them in the same way, except I use different networking devices. Okay. Now for a router, this time, I connect 4 PC. But instead of getting a LAN for all these 4 PC, this time is slightly different. I will instead get 4 networks. So LAN is also network, it's the same thing. So it will be like this. Here, you've got one LAN. And then here, you will get a second LAN. Here, you get a third LAN. And then here, you get a fourth LAN. So in fact, the way I connect is the same. But the end result is different. Look at this. Look at this example. Now I have network 1 here. I have network 2 here. I have network 3, and I have network 4. So if I were to label this one now, I will have, okay, let's say this is LAN 1, I'll just go counter, just go clockwise. So in this case, same setup, but I have 4 networks. Okay, 4 networks means what? Means that we are having different network address. As you will learn in lecture 4, what is a network address? So right now, just think of it as we are in a different network. Although I'm very near to you, but we are actually separated. We are isolated. All right? Okay, yeah. So why this happened? This is because a router is a layer 3 device. So I hope you can start to see the difference here. When we use a router, every connections here, okay, that we connect a cable to, every connections here, it performs a new LAN. But for a hub and a switch, it's different. Doesn't matter how you connect, they are always going to be in the same LAN. Alright? So, which also means that they are slightly different in terms of when you want to use a hub or a switch or a router. So think about this. If I am a network engineer today, okay, so Unify asked me to build a few new networks. The device that I should use is definitely a router. Okay? Now, if I just want to build one LAN, I don't want to have LAN 2, LAN 3, or even more, then I should use a hub or a switch. Purely because they are cheaper, and then they also they serve the purpose. Alright? So, this concept, if you want to look at the slides, let's go back to the slides. So, for today's slides, you need to open these slides. Which is lecture 02B. Okay, and then I will go to this page here. You skip all the way down until here. Overview of the LAN boundary. So, what I have just shown you is a LAN boundary. And why is this important? It's so that you know, let's say today I walk into a room, and then in that room I have 100 machines. But it doesn't mean that all 100 of them actually is in the same network. They could be in different network. Okay, so this is what we want to see in the first half of this lecture. Like, how do we actually find out which LANs you belongs to? Are we in the same LAN or are we not? Alright, now, right now you might be thinking, okay, so why do we why do we even want to talk about LAN? Like, why do you want to go into your LAN 1 and then I go into my LAN 2? Why not we just, everyone, be united? And then the whole internet belongs to a same big network. And we don't even have to learn about these slides right now. Okay, now the thing is, it doesn't work that way. Because there is a few physical constraints and also some technical constraints, like there is only that much or that many machines that you can put in the LAN until you run out of private address space. And also there is only that much machines that you can connect to a network device physically until you run out of ports. So yeah, which is why this is some of the design issues. So we always have to put different people into different networks. And sometimes it's also on security reason, because you don't want to have Apple company and Google, they are sharing the same network. Then tomorrow you see the new iPhone 13 looks like Google Pixel, or the Google Pixel looks like iPhone 13 because they can see each other data. So there is also security reasons why we want to put people into different network. There's also reason like performance issue. So for example, if I have 10 people who use the same network, compared to a network with only 2 people is sharing, of course the smaller user number of user will be faster, the network will be faster, because then the router don't have to process that many traffic and that many packets at the same time. So there are many reasons to why you want to have 2 people into different LAN instead of just one big whole family network. Alright, we are friends, everybody are friends, but we just cannot be in the same LAN. Okay, so because of that, then we have this concept of LAN boundaries. Okay, before that, means more security encryptions. Yes, purpose. Thank you. Purpose tells us a very important, purposeful message. Like what I said earlier, one of the reasons is we want to have more security, so we have different LANs. Alright, so if you look at this, what we want to learn right now is you should be able to tell the boundaries of a LAN by the end of this class. Meaning that if I give you a network like this, you should be able to tell me, okay, although it looks like really complex, there are so many things here, but there is only one network. You have to tell this like confidently, there is only 2 networks, or there is only 3 networks. Alright, so how do we know the boundaries? Like what I said earlier, you look at the type of networking device that we use to build this network. So for this example, the very first example is a hub, which is this thing here. And this is what I'll be showing you later. Once we unlock the theory, then we can see the physical thing, okay? So yeah, again, I just want to remind you, in YouTube, there is a 10 or 15 seconds delay. So what I ask you might be delayed. So I hope you understand. And then anytime you have any questions while I'm showing you anything new, you can always ask on the chat, because I'm always looking at the chat right now. Okay, so coming back to this, example 1 is a hub. So I also have a switch. Using the theory that I showed you earlier, doesn't matter how many devices you put into a hub or a switch, they will always give you only one LAN. So in this case, if I draw the boundaries, it will be this line here. See this line here. Okay, because it doesn't matter how many devices. Okay, if you want, I can also circle all this in green color. This green color are N devices. Okay, I just color this so that you can get it clearly. So we have a few N devices here. Now, it doesn't matter how we connect really. As long as they are to a switch or a hub, then they are in one network. Now, after that, you see we have routers here. So these routers is where the boundary will stop. This is the cutting point. This will be the edge. So every time you go until a router edge, that is the stop or the border of your network. Okay? Which means that if I have something like this, if I have a router like this, this one on the top green color is one network, LAN 1. Here is LAN 2. So this is how you remember, very easy. Every time you have a router, every time you connect a cable to a router, it will give you one new network. Okay, so if this example is a bit confusing, it's because it is. So maybe I can give you better example. Let's see if we have better example next. Okay, let's try to look at this network here. Again, same questions. We want to know how many network we have here. So it will help if you think that, okay, this is a bit hard. You want to find out what are the network device and what are the end device first. Then, okay, we can do that. So I will now color code this. All the yellow color one are end device, which are the device that you use or the device that are servers. All right. So you have a few end devices here. And then the one that I color code in green color is the network device. So we have a hub here, we have a switch here, hub here, switch here, and switch here. Now, this is a really, really complex network, which is a bit unfair to you right now because this is the first time you are looking at this. Anyway, it is not important because the concept is the same. It doesn't change. It's still one network because every time we connect anything to a switch or a hub, it always gives us one network. Doesn't matter how complex it gets. So you can have a network as simple as this. I have a switch. I connect to PC1, PC2, PC3, and PC4. Yeah, this one also is one network. Okay? So you see in this diagram, there is also no routers, which make the whole thing easier because when you have router, that is when you will have more networks. Okay, now I want to do a survey first. Before that, let's go this one. Let's see if we can understand this. If we can understand this, which means that somehow you know how to know the boundaries. Okay, so over here, I will again do the same. I color code all the end devices first. Okay, so now printer, PC, all these PCs, printers, servers, they are end devices. Okay, the one in green color will be our network device. So I have two switches here. I have one switch here. I have a hub here. And then I have routers here. Now, same questions. How many networks do we have? Okay, so we have to be careful when we draw. Okay, so you see, every time you see a router, then just go and then you see how many interfaces you have on the router. So for example, in this case, how many routers do we have? How many routers? We have two routers, right? So this is the first router. This is the second router. And the concept is the same. Every time you have a new interface or a new connection to a router, that is where you get a new network. Router is the boundary of the LAN. Okay, so in this case, the answer is already given, but I will just draw this again for you, how I see. So I will look at the first router first. Let's look at the first router. Okay, zoom this in. Now, I have port 1, port 2, port 3. Wait, this is reverse. So from this idea here, I know I have three networks already. Okay, three networks. So don't look at right side, just look at left side first. And because of this concept, now I will draw the LAN boundary. This one here, it will give me one LAN here. This one here, it will give me another LAN here. From here to here. It doesn't matter the internet, okay? Just look at the router boundaries. And then from here to here, this one, the third one, you have another one here. So until now, I already have three LAN. LAN 1, LAN 2, and LAN 3. Okay? So we go to the right side now. Look at this router. Okay, now we are going to look at the second router here, which is this router. Okay? So zoom in. Let's see how many we have. We have one here. We have two here. And we have three here, correct? So if I want to draw the boundaries, this one will give me one boundaries. The next connections will give me another boundaries. And then here I have one more, which is actually the same. but earlier we already have LAN 3. So in this case, if we calculate in total how many we have, actually the answer is 5. Because here I have 1, 2, 3. This one you don't count 2 times. 2 router connect together is in the same network, so we only count them as 1 network, LAN 3, 4, and 5. So yeah, 5. Now what I want you to learn from here is that if you are given a network, and then you are asked how many networks we have here in a very big complex network design. Okay, so the way you see or the way you answer is just by looking at the routers, and then from there you know the router is the edge that will give you the boundaries border. Okay, so in this case it's 5. Now if you have any questions about this concept, please ask me on the chat right now so that I might give you more example which can be simpler if you think this is too hard. So let me know on the chat. So far, is this okay for you? And while I'm waiting, I'll just take some of your questions. So questions 1, if you have multiple router connected to the same LAN, is LAN 1 identified as a different LAN or the same? So yeah, this is a very, very good question. If you have many routers connect to the same LAN, they are all considered as one network. All right. So in this case, let me draw one example for you. So let's say if I have this router. Okay. In the simplest way, this one you have 3 LAN. LAN 1, LAN 2, LAN 3. Depending on how many interface you have. If I connect one more, then this is LAN 4. So this is router. Now if you have 2 routers, let's say you have something like this. Connected together. This thing here is considered as one LAN. Okay? You don't count them as 2 LAN. Now if I connect another PC here, or a router here, doesn't matter, then this one is considered, let's say this is a PC, okay, don't want you to get confused, so this is a PC, this is a PC. So in this case, you actually have 3 LAN, LAN 1, LAN 2, and LAN 3. Okay, so I hope you see the idea here. It's really simple if you get it. Just look at the routers. Okay? Now, let's go back to some of your questions. I hope you are still with me. This is not a good way to start a morning lecture. Anyway, yeah, is LAN 3 any different from other LAN? Okay, this is again a very good question. So, from what you see here, LAN 3 is actually different. So, all your LAN 1, LAN 2, LAN 4, and LAN 5, we call them N networks. Okay? So what you see in green color now are called the N networks. What you see in red color is called the core network. So this is a core network. These are N network. N network is like our network, your network right now, my network right now. But for me to go to you, it goes through a series of router like I said earlier. And what is on the internet? A lot of routers that can be owned by Maxis, Cellcom, TM, or whoever is sharing the routers. So on the internet, we call them core networks. Router go to another router is called core networks. Some people call them ISP network. Some people call them a backbone network. They are all the same thing. All right. Meanwhile, N networks, like our network, we have iPhone, we have MacBook, we have iPad that is connecting to a router that goes onto the internet that are called the end network, end user network. Alright? So, next question. What if it is like R1 to PC1 to PC2? Okay, very good questions. Let me visualize the questions. So, for those who need context, the question is on the chat next to you. So, Your friend, I'm sorry, I don't know whether this is Japanese or if this is Korean. So I cannot read your name. Okay, you have R1 to PC to R2. So normally it means this, to connect to a PC, connect to a router. Now, how many LAN do we have here? This is a very good question, okay? But actually this is out of your scope. So if you don't get this, this is fine. I think I need to visualize this properly. Give me a second. So let's say this is from the questions from the chat. Yeah, this is R1, this is R2. How many networks you have? In fact, you have two networks. Two. So your PC itself acts like a router. So every time you connect two routers to one PC, you are actually in different network, two different networks. So you have LAN 1 here, you have LAN 2 here. So let's label this properly, L1 and L2. L1 means LAN 1, L2 means LAN 2. So yeah, this is a special concept where if you connect one PC to two network or two routers, then they are actually in two different network, two LAN. Which is true, I think, which is true. Like now, if you connect your PC to a Wi-Fi network, and then you also connect to using a LAN cable, you have two IP address, correct? That means you are in two different network. So yeah, that is correct. So coming back to the slides here. Okay, I think we are done with this concept called the LAN boundaries. So I think by now you should be able to know, if you are given a very complex network architecture like this, would you be able to know, or would you be able to count how many networks do we have here? Okay, now you might ask, why is this important? Like, why I want to know this? Okay, it is not immediately clear right now, until one day if you work as a network engineer, that you have to take care of many different sites. For example, in Utah, we are not rich enough to hire one network engineer to take care of one lab. Because we have, like, in FICT building alone, we have 8 labs. Yeah, 8 labs. So we have one guy who will take care of all the 8 labs. And that guy would have to know which PC belongs to the network in first lab, which PC belongs to the network in the second lab, and things like that. Because we, of course, we don't want all the labs to be in the same network, right? So this is why somehow one day you will find that important. So for now, it is only important to you because it could be part of the exam. Okay, that's the only important thing right now. Okay, yeah, if you're clear about this, then we will go back to the three devices here. Yeah, now we're going to do some unboxing together because you already know the difference. Before that, one more thing. Okay, so earlier when we start this class, we learned that we have three different kind of network device. Okay, if I connect everything using a hub, this one is one big LAN, correct? Now, if I do the same thing, I connect them using a switch. This time it's a switch. So I connect them together. Again, all of them will belong to one same big network. So this is still one same LAN. So now that brings us to another question. Then why we want to have switch and router? Sorry, why we want to have hub and a switch? So now what we want to see is why sometimes you want to use a hub, and then why sometimes you use a switch. Now router is totally different ballgame. I'm not even comparing routers here because router is used for different things. Okay, hub and switch is very simple. Like the girl in the high school, they don't know anything yet. Okay, when come to university, suddenly they become so pretty and then they know much more. Okay, so yeah, hub and switch is purely to connect end device so that they join a same LAN. That simple. but routers is to build more and more new networks. Okay, it's not that it is more expensive. Okay, Plankton is saying switch and hub. Why? One of the reasons is expensive. Of course, everything is about money. Today you are here because you hope that one day when you graduate, you get a good job. It's not because you want to learn about network. So yeah, it's still about money. So when in the exam, if you have questions like that, and then you are not sure about the answer, just write about money. More expensive or cheaper is always correct. So yeah, you are right. Hub and switch. One of the reasons is because hub is cheaper. Okay? So if, to make this easy, if you are poor, if AF, just buy a hub, don't even have to think. But if you have some money and then you can choose between a hub and a switch, then this is when you have to think. So actually there are differences. Okay, I'm going to show you how they are different. So first difference is in terms of the performance. Okay, so if this is a hub, okay, when PC1 send a piece of data to PC2, okay, so let's say I have a picture that I'm sending from PC1 going to PC2. Okay, now in this case, when the data transfer from PC1, it goes into the hub, that same piece of data is, of course, they will be sent to PC2, which is the original destination here. Sorry, this is PC2. Okay, now it is also at the same time being sent to all other devices on the network. So this is how it works. When you send a data to a hub, the hub will simply broadcast the data to everyone else that is currently connected to him. Okay, so this is the very important concept. Hub is not too smart. So he will not know how to send only to PC2. The only thing hub can really do is, I will still send definitely, but I will just send to everyone and hopefully the rightful destination or the guy who is supposed to get the data go and process the data. So coming back to this example, when I send from PC1 to PC2, PC3 will also get the same picture that I'm sending from PC1 to PC2. PC4 will also get the same picture, which is a bit dangerous if you think about it. Like, okay, now if I'm chatting with my girlfriend and then I send something that, you know, couples do, right? Okay, I don't know because I'm not experienced in that. So this is actually dangerous because then your housemate will also get to see something that he's not supposed to see because they are all connected to the same hub. Alright, so another example. Let's say if you have PC1, PC2, PC3. Okay, this is still the same thing, PC4. Now, if I connect more PCs, say PC5, PC6, PC8, okay? So, the same concept, if PC2 now send a data to PC8. So, by right, it is supposed to happen like this. Go to the hub, and then go to PC8. Just like that, point to point, so easy. But hub cannot do that, because it's too cheap. So, when the data come here, okay? It will send here. It will also send to everyone else that is connected to him at the same time. That is a hub, which is like a dumb thing. Okay, but it does the job because somehow PC8 still get the data. The only problem is you have so many people who shouldn't get that data actually somehow ended up with that data, which is a security issue if you ask me. And it's also bad for performance because you see, I send one picture to my friend, but this picture have to be replicated, have to be copied so many times to be sent to other people. Okay, don't even think about whether it's right or wrong. Just think about the impact on the network performance that you have. It is going to slow down your network by quite a lot because now one thing that you send will have to be multiplied for so many other PCs. Okay, this is just one packet. And in the real network, it is like you're sending bytes, millions of bytes of packets at the same time, right? So yeah, this is a hub. So I will take some questions from the chat right now, okay? Does this mean if PC1 decide to DOS the hub, the other PC is also affected? Yes, this is correct. These two people are my favorite people right now. I hope one day I learn Japanese and then I can read your name. And also purpose, ask a very good question. Yes, you are right. So just now, I'm saying that I sent a picture. Other people get it. Okay lah, never mind. You want to look at the picture or you don't want, it's your choice. But if I send a virus, then yes, everyone will get the virus. And that time you cannot say, I don't want the virus. Okay, so yeah, if PC1 decide to DOS the hub, other PC is also affected. That is also correct. Which means that whatever thing you do, good or bad, everyone else that is in the same LAN right now will get to feel what is happening that happened to you. Okay, so this is the hub, which is not okay. If you ask me, it's not okay. Unless you're really, really poor, then just get a hub. Okay, so next thing. Because of this problem, we don't want to use a hub, which is why you should always pay a little bit more for a switch. So you see, what happened now if I change this whole thing to a switch? So same network design, nothing changed except now I replace the hub with the switch. And the same thing happened. PC1 sent a data to PC2. Now this time, it is going to be okay because switch is smarter. Switch will not send to everyone. Instead, switch will do a unicast. So unicast means that I send one-to-one from the sender to the receiver, to the destination. It will not go anywhere else. Okay? So let's say in this example, the data go from PC1 into the switch. The switch is actually smart. He will check the destination by looking at the MAC address. If you remember, earlier we learned about MAC address, which is the physical hardware address for all the machines. Okay, now we don't want to go into detail right now. Just think about this. Switch check your MAC address, and by that he know how to send to the rightful owner only one-to-one. This is not going to go to PC3 or PC4. Okay, so that is the difference between a hub and a switch. Now, if you ask me which device should I use, I really cannot tell you. It depends on the context, like, do you want to save money? Or do you need security? Or do you care about network performance? Then that's how you decide. Should you go with a hub or a switch? Alright? So, yeah, this is the difference. So I can give you 5 minutes to kind of think about what I've just said until now. If you want, you can also replay the video in high speed for 5 minutes. And while I set up the desk so that I can do some unboxing for you, okay? We have talked about hub, switch, routers, and how we use them. So it's time to really look at them in person so that you can remember them. Okay, so yeah, just give me 5 minutes. I'll see you back in 5 minutes for the unboxing. That is not the end. After unboxing, then we will start to build our own network using what we learned right now. Okay, so see you in 5 minutes. Sorry, so I was answering the questions from the chat. So hub is nice if you use for family, but switch is better if you're working for company. So why you love your company people more than your family? Buy a switch for your family. Because I know you're thinking about security. In company, you need security, but in-house, you also need security. Because if you buy a hub, first thing, it will be slower. Second thing, what if you have a brother who is currently going through some puberty? So he might be watching something that you don't want to see, correct or not? So yeah, just use switch. Don't buy any hub unless you really hate your boss, you really hate the company that you are working in, then you buy a hub. You put a hub in for them and then you resign the next day. I find that when we watch some video on YouTube, next day my family also have the same suggested video. Oh my god, Ang, I think you should move out. Don't stay with your parents anymore. They are checking on you. Did they add you on Instagram and Facebook also? This is bad. Move out, move out. It's nothing to do with hug. It doesn't work that way. Because YouTube is a layer 5. In one of the class, you will learn that we have actually layer 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the computer network. So hub is layer 1. It's a hardware device. YouTube is an applications on layer 5. So whatever you see on YouTube will not show up, like your recommendation will not show up on your parents' YouTube, alright? Okay, so yeah guys, you can chat among each other first. Let me settle the table for unboxing.
But
Hi everyone, I'm back. I'm not sure whether this is the best angle, but anyway, let me try again. So, before that, let me answer some questions from the chat. Noodle is very spicy. We cannot answer that. What is the use of hub and switch when we have routers and wireless connection now? Okay, Jory, that is a good question. The router and the wireless routers you have now is actually a combination of router and switch. So the thing that TM gives to you, that modem, you cannot see me now because I only have one camera. So yeah, that device that TM gives to you when you pay 100 something, that is a switch router combo. It's a 2-in-1 device. So it's also a router, it's also a switch. So that they don't have to give you two devices. Do you get what I mean? Otherwise, then you have to find one more power socket to connect a switch and a hub. So it's not you don't need a switch. It's already built into your router. Okay. Wireless connection is Wi-Fi routers with our routers. Yes, that's correct. So let's do some unboxing. What we have here, first device. I hope the first one. Okay, this is a... This is a hub for poor people. So if you have this, if you see this one, this box in your boyfriend's house, please find another boyfriend. She cannot take care of you financially. So this is a hub. Let's see what we have inside here. You might not see this device, okay? Because this one is really, not many people use them anymore. So what we have here is some labels. Okay, this is not a real unboxing channel, so I won't go through all the things that we have inside. Okay, now let's just look at the hub. Okay, so this one here, what you see here, is a network hub. So this is a hub from 3Com, so which is a very dumb device, but at least it does the job. This is not mine, I stole it from the lab, don't worry. I'm financially supported by my girlfriend. Okay, so yeah, you see at the back, all these are not cable, not port. This one is just designed in like the Sydney Opera House. This is all you put where you put in the LAN cables. So this is actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is the 8 ports, means that maximum you can put in 8 device connect and then build a LAN that have 8 device. So yeah, nothing else. You see nothing else. So simple, so clean, so minimalist. In fact, I like the design more than the switch. But too bad it's too dumb. So yeah, nothing to see here except it's one-handed, so light, I can hold it like that. And nothing else. This is really only useful if you want to host a LAN party. Okay, then you want your friend over to play games together. Without needing the internet, like in a hostel, then yeah, you can do that, you can use this. Other than that, I don't think you want to use a hub. Because switch is also actually not that much expensive than a hub. Okay, so let's keep this one here. This is like if you put it outside the corridor, also no people is going to take this thing. It will still be here 3 days later. Then let's keep this back. This one let the lab officer do it. I only unbox, I don't want to put it back. Later they put it back. Okay, now let's upgrade our network. Now we have a switch. So this one here is really starting to get expensive because now you see the Cisco name here. Let's see what we have inside. So yeah, we have this thing, a power cable, and then this is the switch. Okay, let's see what we have here. They give me a screwdriver, which looks really cute. Like, okay, later we are going to use this to open this thing. Okay, we don't want to just look at the outside, we want to see what is inside. 50 light, I'll open this one. I'm just kidding, I'm going to open it anyway. Yeah, and then this is the cable that you already see. This is a console cable. So let's look at the switch. This is a Cisco network switch. And again, we have 8 ports here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is an 8-port switch. But now you see it's a bit different already because you have this thing called a console here, which you don't have on the back of the hub. And then you have this one. This is where you connect the switch to the router or to the to some other networking devices. So this is a really, really fast port. Faster, this one is faster than what you have here. Okay, so yeah, let's just take a look at the outside. It looks very clean, minimalist. I like this also, but no Apple logo. The only bad thing about this is there is no Apple logo here. Okay, and then what else you have here? On the other side is really nothing except some cooling ventilations. Yeah. So like what we have just seen earlier, a switch and a hub. It's not much different. They do the same thing. You connect the device here, they go into the same LAN. But you see here, this is different. You can connect the switch to the router, and from there you can go to the internet. A hub cannot do that. Okay? Now how about this? This is a console where this is where you are putting this cable here. This cable. We have seen this the other day. So this is a console cable, and these ends will go into here. So it's okay, ready. I'm going to make this. I don't want to talk so that you can hear the ASMR sound here. So satisfying. Let me do that again. I like this sound so much. Again. So fun. Ah, so nice. Okay. Yeah. So this one, why we do this? Why we do this thing? It's because I want to connect this thing to a PC. Now, why we do that? Again, look at this thing. There is no I/O, no input, no output, no monitor. You cannot see anything that is being displayed. You cannot type on it. There's nothing else you can really do except maybe some weightlifting. So yeah, if you want to configure or make any changes here, like you want to set VLAN one day, we will learn how to set VLAN or anything else, you need to have keyboard, mouse, and then a monitor to show the system message and then to do some programming on it. So how can you do that? You connect this one to a PC that has an input output, like already have a mouse or a keyboard. Then using the PC, you can get inside this router, and then it is just like any other PC that you have. It will display the, because it has OS as well, okay, it has its own operating system, and then you can see whatever things that is being prompt on the screen. That is when you can start to make some changes or make some programming on the switch. So yeah, this is why we call this a managed switch. Managed switch means that you can make changes, you can do programming. But first, you need to connect this thing to a PC, like my Mac here, to see the inside, the software of this switch. Okay. So yeah, this is a network switch. Now, after that, I'm going to show you a router. And then we come back to this switch. You want to open the inside of the switch. Or maybe we open it now. Let's open it now. Anybody want to see the inside of the switch? I can open this, but I cannot guarantee I can put them back together. So it's a risk lah. Maybe this month I will only get half month salary. Anybody want to see the inside? Okay, if you want, then let's unbox therapy. Unbox therapy, help out of it. Alright, so if you want, then let's do this. But this might be the last time we see this switch, in case I void the warranty. So how many screws we have here? We have one here, two here. You can watch this while drinking your coffee. There's nothing too technical here. Just let me unbox. Luckily, I am an IKEA fan, so I'm very good with screwdriver. So just let me unbox this. This size make me think something like, why so small? Why so small? Okay, one screw done. Let me find the other one. Okay, we have one more here. Let's unbox. Let's unscrew this. No people want to give me like. Give me like, help me with the algorithm. So stingy, these people, so stingy. I'm sweating here, you don't want to give me light. Okay, I don't play any music because I want you to hear the ASMR sound. Okay, I think we are done. Let's see whether we can get in. Okay, there should be no other screws. Let's try this. I'm not sure if I have enough strength to open this thing. But you already liked the video, what to do? Oh no, how to open this thing? Guys, give me a moment. I'm sure it's this way. Please don't give me any pressure. Oh yeah, it's open. Yes, it's open. Let's see. Wow, what we have here. Oops. Okay, give you a good angle. So this one, let's zoom down. Can we zoom in a bit more? Wait, let me find this. Wow, let's see what we have here. So beautiful. This plate is non-removable plate. This is good design because if it's removable, then we know one day we will lose the plate. So this is good design. But it's very bad security, only 3 screws. To protect the whole switch, only 3 screws. I can get in already. And why is like so empty? Like when we open this one, you see, nothing inside. The box is so big, but nothing inside. Thing is like, the potato chips that you buy, inside 70% air, 30% chips. Nothing good inside. Okay, now let's go through the hardware and then we see what we have. So here, I can show you like this. This one is the Cisco chip. This is the one that makes Cisco so special because this chip here understands switching, this one only understands switching. Later when you see the router one, it can do routing. So this is the one that powers everything from what we are going to learn in this subject. What to do when you get a packet, how to send, where to send, the way you send it is all controlled by this IC here. This is just the heatsink to cool the device. And then, what else we have here? Okay, this is the ROM. This thing here is the ROM. Okay, let me give you a good angle. This thing here, it could be this or this, I'm not quite sure, but one of them is the ROM. And that will hold the operating system, just like your PC. If you're using Windows 10, or you're already running the leaked version of Windows 11, you need to install your OS on the hard disk or your SSD, right? And then on your motherboard, you have something called a battery or something, CMOS or something. Yeah, that thing holds the startup information, and then it will load your OS from the hard disk to the memory or something so that you can use a machine. Now, the same thing for networking device. The OS is called Cisco iOS, not Apple iOS. Somehow they share the same name, okay? Cisco iOS, the OS is safe here. So every time you start the power, it is load from here to the processor or to the RAM somewhere here, which I don't know where is it. Yeah, so anything else interesting? Let's see here. This is where you have all the ports connected. So it's covered here, I can show you. This is just some IC here. Some battery, some transistor that I also don't know what they do, but they are here. Looks so colorful, like the M&N that I don't know. Any one of you like M&N? My favorite color is green color. This is my favorite M&N color. Okay, I think that's pretty much it. Let's zoom up to get a wider view. So, this is the internal of a switch. The important thing is, of course, the IC here. Heatsink, ROM. In one of the slides, you have the schema also. Then you can see what is what lah. But now I just briefly show you the real thing here. And now the next question is, can I put them back together? Okay. Broadcom chip. The ROM is updatable. Yes, ROM is always updatable. I can show you one day how you update the ROM. That is a command that you can do to update whatever there's already flashed into the ROM right now. So what else? What questions do you have? Guys, what do you want me to do? If you don't have, then I will just close this thing. But cannot ask me to blend it. I cannot blend this thing. I don't have this big blender that I can blend. Oh, I think I spoiled that. It's not going to go back anymore. Anyway, it's okay. we have many, many switch like this here. If one of these is missing, nobody is going to find out. So that is okay. Let's put this aside. And then we take a look at a router. Drop test. Let's do a drop test using this one. Okay, this is the only drop test I can do in this stream. I'm not that rich to drop a switch, okay? Okay, hub and switch similar inside. Yeah, only the chip are different. Most other things like the heatsink and everything else, they are still the same except because switch is smarter, so the IC is also more complex. The ISA design is also more complex. Okay, what other tests you want? Durability test. I don't have a hammer. I cannot hammer the thing. So let's assume it's durable. Because you see, right now we are still connected. That means the hardware is very durable. Most of the hardware that we use is either from Huawei or Cisco, the networking thing. Okay, now let's look at the most expensive unboxing. A router. Okay, let me point this here. Okay. Should I play you some BGM so that it gives us more feeling? I cannot play, that is echo. You play your own BGM. Okay lah, let's do ASMR. Let's see what we have here. Whew, this is 8K. My 1 month salary, so I have to be very careful. So another advice, if you want to be rich, don't teach, go and do business. Okay, wow, it's still in the plastic bag. Have you ever feel like a plastic bag in another plastic bag? That switch is so big, so heavy, I cannot hold it with one hand for too long. But the design is almost the same. You see, almost the same, a square box, same color. This green color, mint green, is the Cisco signature color. So what we have here is a Cisco 18000. This is a router. So from the front, it's really no different. You cannot tell whether it's a switch or a router from the front until you look at the back. Okay, wow, this is so heavy. Look at my muscle, it's already coming up. Okay, now, a router looks like this. Actually, if you ask me, it's more handsome than a switch. Okay, so 1841 is the model. Of course, you have different models, like some is faster. Internally, you have more RAMs, you have better IC, and you might have more ports. But yeah, whatever you have, Cisco 1841, you can always configure them. Like if you need more ports, you can buy a new card and put it here. And then this is the serial one. So now let me show you what the ports are. Okay, first thing, this FE. Okay, zoom in. Now look at this FE here. This is FE01, FE00. This is where you connect a LAN cable. Wait, let me get a LAN cable. Hi, I'm back. Oops. Okay, now this is where you put in the LAN cable, just like that. Another ASMR is coming. Ready? Wow, so nice. Okay, so what we have here, I think I haven't break it, luckily. So this one will give you one network. Just now, what do we learn? Every time we connect a router and then we put in a new cable, remember, that will give you a new network. So yeah, what you just see here is if I connect this one to another PC, this is one network. Okay? So over here, if I ask you a simple question, how many network do you think I can build with this switch right, this router right now? How many? In total. Can I build one LAN, two LAN, three LAN, or four LAN? Four LAN. Yeah, that is a good try. That is a good try. But I think you are too innocent because 03 and 02 is too innocent. Now let's zoom in again. Let's zoom in and then look at this. Okay, you see the label here. This is a console. So console is not FE. When you connect to FE, means fast Ethernet, or sometimes you see G means gigabit Ethernet. That is to build network. This is not, this is console, means this is the blue color cable that I will put in. This cable here. Remember this cable? I'm back. So this cable here, this one here, will go in here. And this is to connect to another PC so that you can get inside this router and then do some programming and do some coding. So this is not a network. This is just a managing port that you want to connect to, and then you can do some programming in it. Alright, so this is not. Now, this one here is aux. Aux is similar to console, just another way you connect it to a PC to do some management or configuration stuff. So again, it's a good guess, but the right answer is actually 2. 1 and 2. These two are not. So with this 1841 routers, by default, you can build 2 network. Okay? But of course, if you want more, then you see there is actually a slot here that you can buy another card or some expansion card, and then you can install it, then you can build more networks. Okay, now let's look at one. Wow, my hand cannot tahan. Okay, zoom in first. So what you see here, this one here, is called a serial connections. You have already seen the cable in the other day. Today, you want to see how it is done. So using this cable here, this one, is to connect one router to another router. So if I connect a router to a PC or a router to a switch, then it becomes, they are still in one network, okay? Or two network, depending on how many you connect. But routers have to connect to another router so that the whole internet can be connected together, okay? The idea is like you cannot have one router, okay? You cannot have one router and then from Penang. So let's say I'm here in Kampak, you are in Penang here. I don't have a cable that is so long, I can just come to Gamba, pull one long cable until Penang, and then we are connected. Cannot. Okay, too far. You don't have a cable that is too long. So you need to pull into a middle. So let's say from Penang to Gamba, you need to pull here. Then one router, pull here. Second router, third router, fourth router, until Penang router. So there are many routers in between from a source to a destination. Okay, and how we connect all the routers together? Using this cable. Okay, it will go in like this. This one here goes in like this. Okay, let me get a good angle for you. Like this. But this one no ASMR sound. This one just the happiness feeling when you put this in, you know you're almost there, you can almost go home. Okay, so yeah, this is how you connect. So naturally the other end here will go to another router. Okay, I don't have too many hands, so I cannot show you how I connect to another router. But I think you get the idea here. So this is a router. Yeah, so that's pretty much all the important ports that you need to know for the three networking devices. So this one is to build network. This one is to configure. This one is from routers to router. And then this is on and off. This is power. That's it. Yeah. Now, if you want me to open this one here, we need 300 likes. Which is not going to happen because we don't have 300 people here. So we won't be opening this one. This one is too expensive. I cannot pay this thing back. I hope you are happy with the unboxing. So now, we will take... I will just put all of them here so that you can take a closer, close-up look. Maybe some product showcase. And then let's take a 10-minute break until 11:30. When we come back, we are going to start to see how we can build your own network using Packet Tracer. So again, for those who have not downloaded Packet Tracer, you have to download the packet tracer right now. Go to TryHackMe, let me show you how. So for those who are still in your PJ and coffee, yeah, this is what you're supposed to do. Go to... Oh, I'm not indexed yet. Yeah, I'm here. So the TryHackMe link is already up. You can just go and click here. This will bring you to TryHackMe. So we are going to do Bob the Builder today. Okay, just click on this thing. Then it will bring you to the TryHackMe page. Nobody is here yet. I feel so alone here. Come and join me here. So yeah, if you go to task number three, okay, there is a link here where you can download the game file. Now, you have to use your own personal Google account to download this again, like usual. And inside here, okay, once you downloaded that, you should have. Okay, let me just download this thing. It's not that big anyway. So if you don't have a Unify, you better start to download now, okay? Is the room private? So you cannot join. Yeah, it's supposed to be private, right? Okay, let me try the access. Okay, let me try. But before that, you install Packet Tracer first. Let me show you how to do it. So once you go to your... Okay, later, you will see this thing. Once you are able to download, you will see this thing. You install this program on the machines while we are having a break. While we have the break, then later when we come back, we will have to use this program to play the game. Okay? So let me try to make the setting here. I make it private because it's just for you. It's only for you. Not anyone can come in. Why private? It's supposed to work. Anyone else can go in. You see, this is not private at all. I am never private. I always overshare on social media. Let me see how to do this. No need to log in, it's free. Can you try this link? Can you try the link on the chat? Please let me know if you can get in. Okay, I log in. I think that means you might have to do an account first. So it's not me, it's you. You make me feel so insecure. Okay, guys, so I think it's a bit late, 11:35. Okay, I'll give you 10 minutes to get in, make an account. Remember to use a very cool name because this name will stay with you for 3 months and you cannot change them along the way. So make sure you use something like XXX. Purpose XXX or something like this, okay? Yeah, the game that you use for your IGN lah. And then once you're ready, download, install Packet Tracer. When we come back, we will need Packet Tracer to play the game together, okay? So I'll see you back in 10 minutes. Any email, you don't have to follow your real name. Use a name that people cannot recognize you because we are going to do some bad thing here. So I see you back again in 10 minutes.
Carry my Remix. Remix.
running through the city with a little broken soul. So I'm light it up like dynamite. This is the sky. Watch me break the face with another light. Shining through the city with a little broken soul. Come on, light it up like dynamite. Hey guys, welcome back. So it's time for, it's game time. The moment everyone is waiting for. Okay, now, I'm going to tell you briefly about Try and Me and what you need to do, and then I think what's the best way for you to do all the challenge that I've designed for you. So, yeah, for those who are not in yet, you're supposed to make a Try Me account. So this Try Me is a really, really cool website. By the way, this video is not sponsored by Try Me, but yeah, it's a really cool website where if you want to learn more about how to hack Domino Pizza for free pizza data for your lunch, or how to hack Food Panda so that you can always use the new voucher code without limitation, or how to do something like hacking Maple or something, yeah, along the range of web hacking, reconnaissance, or things like that. This is a very good website because it has so many resources and ROMs that can teach you how to become a hacker. Of course, no, but you cannot be a hacker in one day, all right? So yeah, this website here, it is going to, at least there are many ROMs, some are free, some you have to pay money, that you can try to learn about hacking. But if you don't want to do that, that's fine, because next semester when you take the security subject, I'll also be teaching you some of the things that you can find here. Alright, so yeah. And Try Me is really cool. You have all the scoreboard, and this one actually updates in real time. That means if you got these answers correctly, then your friends can actually see that you are not sleeping. Okay. But it's fine, it's fine. If you don't want to do this, this is up to you. This score will not be translated in any way to your assessment marks. It's just something I think is fun for us to play together. Because if you play this alone, it's not fun. Nobody play Mobile Legend or nobody play Wangzhe alone. That is like forever alone level 99999. Okay, the most forever alone thing I ever done is watch a movie myself. I don't know anybody here, go to eat steamboat by yourself. Okay, so yeah, coming back to this. So it only shows the top 10 scorer lah. Of course, it cannot show everyone here. So if you see your names here, that means you're doing a great job. So in most of the challenge, there are many tasks. And I will be doing some of the walkthrough if I think I need to, but if it is really easy one, then I'll just leave them for yourself. All right? So yeah, it's really simple. Let me try to show you one of the example on how I do this. So again, this is like, if you get it correctly, you get the marks. You won't be penalized if you do this wrongly. There's no time limitation as well, so we can just pick it as just something really fun to play with. So let's say, for example, first question is task one. This is something that we already talked about back in our first class. So we learned about three kind of addresses. Remember that we have IP address, we have MAC address, and then we have port numbers. So based on what we have just learned, you can answer all the questions already. In fact, you don't even have to read any slides for this class, I think. Okay. So you see, if I get this correctly, IP address, then you get correct answers. I already done this. So I will just use the second one as an example. What are the type of network address that is used to identify a host within a network? So remember, we have three addresses: IP, MAC, and port. IP address is to identify hosts from a network to another network. A MAC address, which is also your physical address, is to ID a PC or a host within your own network. And port number is for all the apps. Okay, so every app will have their own numbers. So you see, if you do not know the answer, you can always click on hint and then you say, it's either these three. So if you think this is correct, you just type MAC. Oops, what am I doing? Just type MAC address. It's not case sensitive, I think. So yeah, then you get it correct. Okay, so like, what are the type of addressing scheme that is used to identify different services? So how do we know this data should go to Facebook or Instagram or whatever apps that you're running? Or numbers. Then you get it correct. So as you progress, you will see your marks will go up. Wow. Let's see who is the new winner here. Momo, 6266. Momo is a good hacker, but he put 6266 here to show us his IC number. This is not a smart hacker. No, I don't think that is. I think it's something else, but yeah. Keep it coming. This is what I want to see. Everybody fight each other in Try Hack Me, but don't fight each other in real. Okay, so I won't be showing all this because I think you should already know all the answers if you watch my previous stream. So for this class, we'll go straight to task number three. And this is when we start to build our own LAN. So early on, we have already learned we can build network using a hub, a switch, or a router. Now we are going to actually do it. So to do so, you will need to download the file, and then you open the file in Packet Tracer. So for those who are not familiar, Packet Tracer is a networking design tool by Cisco, which is really, really useful. Like anybody who learn networking will definitely use Packet Tracer. So once you install, you might get a bunch of error message like license expired or something. Okay, close all the error message until you have a screen like this. So this is a Packet Tracer, how it looks like. And you want to open the file that is given to you. The file is called Bob the Builder. I have it here on my desktop. So for you, depending on where you download the file to, you just click on the open button here, this open button, like how you open a doc file. And then you click Bob the Builder and you should see a network being loaded. All right. So once you do that, you will get two screens. One is the network screen. Another one is the instruction screen. So I don't know how big your screen is, because you have to look at this video, you have to open Packet Tracer. So yeah, I would suggest right now is a good time for you to go and get an external monitor so that you can have more screen estate to play with. Okay, just tell your mom, I need a monitor, otherwise I cannot see my handsome lecturer, he's so small. So just tell him that you need a monitor. Or if you don't have, or you're using a laptop right now, just try to play around with whatever window size that is comfortable for you. And then yeah, this is Packet Tracer. I'm also looking for a sponsor for this channel. Until now, no people put ads on my channel. No, some people did, but they didn't pay me. No, I'm just kidding. Okay, this channel is not monetized. I didn't get any money from here. So let's come to Packet Tracer. Now what do you see here? First thing, three color. It's not important. Important is why we use Packet Tracer. So let's talk about Packet Tracer first. So today I might take maybe 10 minutes more from you, sir. So Packet Tracer is, like I say, a networking design tool. And it is here because it helps us to design and simulate network. So in simple words, we want to test our design before we build the real network. So for example, let's say today I'm working for a network company. Say maybe I'm working for Utah, and Utah want to upgrade the campus network, because once all the OTL students come back for physical class, then of course we have more traffic. So we need to make sure we can know people post on UC or Instagram, why I pay facility money but Wi-Fi is so slow, we don't want that. So we are upgrading. Now of course to upgrade, I need to buy better switch, newer switch, more expensive, more capable switch or routers. And I need to redesign the thing, like how I connect from UniFi to my switch, from the ISP network to my network. How do we do that? There are so many ways, and some ways are better than the other way in their own way. And how do I know which way is the best, like which is the most cost effective, which is the right device I should be buying and stuff like that. Now, of course, there's no answer. If I just talk like this to the camera, I'm not going to find an answer. So you will have to really have a plan, a design, and then you want to try it out. So I can have a plan, but I cannot just go all out and then I buy everything that I think it will work. But if it doesn't work, then you have to return to Lazada in 14 days, or you have to return to a hometown in 14 days, after 14 days, because you don't have a job anymore. So we cannot just buy and then we say, oh, it will work or it doesn't work. So this is where we have Packet Tracer. Okay, my mom say need your phone number. Then should I call you daddy? No. You should call me daddy after that. Don't do that, crazy Max. This is too crazy. Okay, now, so Packet Tracer is where we can build the network, and then we try to see whether it will work or it will not work. Okay, so let's take a quick look at what we have here. On the bottom left corner, in Packet Tracer, this is where we find all your device, your end device, your networking device, your cables, and whatever you need to build networks are here at the bottom right corner. Okay, now you can, like, let's say I click on routers, then you will see a list of routers with different models here. if I click on switches, then it will show me all different models of switches. So there are these are the devices that is like Lazada, you just add to your shopping cart and then you can get a device to try on. Okay, so yeah, of course you have end device. End device will be all the PCs, the servers and stuff. And then you have all these other things that we might not be using all of them anyway. So yeah, this is how, this is the where you pull the device that you need later. I'll show you in a while. And then the cables are here. This light thing sign is called a cable. All the cables that we will use later are here. So, and on this side, this is where if you do something wrongly, you can always use this to delete. You can zoom, you can draw with colors. You might want to explore this on your own in a while. I will only show you the essentials, like when we need them, then I'll be showing you that. Okay, so this is packet tracer. Now on the right, this is called the activity window. And what you need to do, of course, the first day you go, your boss will say, I want this, I want that, I want coffee, decaf, more sugar, no cream on top. So yeah, you get all these kind of instructions, and on packet tracer, this is where you see them. All the things you need to do are here, and if you do them correctly, look at the bottom right corner. I hope you can see this on the screen. That is a completion. So you can actually see like how much progress you are making, whether you are in the right directions, whether you are doing things right, things like that. So you can actually see like what you have done right, what is need to be done right, and then everything will be listed so that you know what else you need to do. Okay, so it's like a game where if you get everything right, like what we will have later, you'll get 100%, and then you'll feel proud about myself. Take the 100%, show it to your mom. Mom, I'm talented. Buy me an external monitor. Oh, it's blocked my face. Let me show this again. So here, you see there's a completion here. Oops. See, so this one, it will show you like how much progress you are making. Okay, you see, if I click on this check activity button here, this check activity, you can also see the itemized thing like, okay, how many things is done correctly? How many things else haven't done it? And then this is the score. So in this playthrough, the maximum score you can get is only 45. And you can really see like, okay, what else that needs to be done, what else that is not done properly are all listed in this kind of itemized way. So it's very easy for you to find out like what is not working properly yet, okay? So these are packet tracer. And now I will show you one example, a real example on how we build three networks. Today we'll build three networks, one in the yellow color, one in the blue color, and then one in the green color. And by the end of this playthrough, you will get 100%. So that's the first thing you want to do. You make sure you are able to build a network. And once this is done, only then we go back to try hack me to answer some of these questions. Okay, so I'm going to do this a bit quick because I only have 20 minutes. Somehow this becomes a time challenge. Okay, so packet tracer. Just do some resizing as you think you need to so that you can see everything and instructions by the side. Now, first thing, come to computer networking. When we design network, the first thing that we do always is we need to have a plan, a hardware plan. We call them a blueprint. And from that, you will have the blueprint will consist like what device that we need, how we connect them, where to put which device. Okay, so it's always on the hardware side, and then you go to the software side. Then if the hardware is done, everything is connected. Only we start to put in IP address, only then we start to do routing, the software side. Okay, it's a bit different from in programming it might be different, like you have software and hardware together. In networking, it's always from hardware to software, it's not soft to hard. Okay, soft to hard, only girl like it. Always we start from soft and then it become hard. Sorry children, this is not appropriate for this channel. So yeah, I want you to make sure the pipeline is clear. Always do the hardware. The hardware, you get all the marks. Only you do the software. Okay, so look at the instructions here together. Now, step one, buy hardware. Buy three PC. Okay, so we need three. Place them in LAN 1. Yes, sorry, children. What if this video get banned? And then you cannot replay this lecture anymore. Okay. Okay, come back. Buy three PC. So yeah, this is how I do it. PC are end device. So you go to end device. Okay, end device. The very, very first one at the bottom left. Do I look like a lecturer to you? Okay, come. Then here. Generic. Okay, so you want, it doesn't matter like whether you use a laptop or a desktop, but as long as you have a PC, it's fine. So to standardize things, okay? To standardize things, let's just all of us use generic PC. So I click on the first one, okay? Again, it doesn't mean you have to have exactly the same thing as what I have here, but it's better if you do, okay? So now, if I click here, I just need to, there are two ways. I can click and then I go here, left click here in the drawing pane. Then you will see the device. Or you can also actually just drag, hold your left mouse button and then you drop. So you can always do a drag and drop if you want to. And for my case, I need three PC. Okay, now in this case, if you click the first PC is PC 0. For programmer, array always start with 0, correct? But in this case, I want all of you to start with PC 1. So you just click the first PC 0 and then you just put it aside. Okay. This one, we just put it in the storeroom. We are not going to use this PC anymore. Just buy and put it because we are rich. Then you just take another 3 PC here. So you need PC 1, 2, 3. Make sure the label is correct. Okay, I need all of you to make sure this is correct. PC 1, PC 2, and PC 3. So that we are together on this. Okay. Now, this is in the yellow network. So I'm going to do everything inside the yellow color network, which is this one here. Alright, I bought 3 PC and then place them in LAN 1. So you can just drag them into LAN 1. It doesn't mean you have to follow a certain formations or a certain topology, okay? It doesn't make any difference. Unless you want to draw something with the PC. And then when you look from top down, wow, you write, I love you. Maybe you propose to your girlfriend in this way. So romantic, so geeky. But yeah, what we have here is doesn't matter. You can place them in any formations that you like. Okay, then the next thing. Then the next thing is buy one switch. Okay, buy one switch. Now this switch here, it has to be the same model. And it has to be 2950. So let me show you how I get this switch. Okay, now for you to get the switch, you need to go from here because you are still in the end device. So you go here, this one here. Okay, the second one here. I can zoom this in for you. Let me try to zoom in because this is the first time. Yeah, this one here. Let me get, yeah, this one, the second one, all right? So if you click this, then you'll see actually there is so many kind of different switch that we can use. And you want to click on the first one, 295024, just put it here, okay? Then, I think we are done with the switch. And then the last thing to buy is a router. So a router is 1841. So router is here, this one here, the circle color one, okay? The one that looks like a cylinder. And if you click this, it will show you all the routers that you can buy. And for our first network, we want to use the cheapest router, 1841. This is exactly the router that I just shown you earlier. Exactly the same thing. Okay, so by now, if you have done step one, you should have something similar. You have three PC, one switch, and a router. Okay, now again, placement is not really important. You can just place it anywhere as you like. And then, yeah, if you're done, let's go to step two. So, every time when we do hardware part, you need to make sure you get the right hardware. And then, next step is to connect all of them together. Now, connecting hardware is not as simple as I just take a cable and connect, because first, you need to connect at the correct port, okay? And then you need to use the correct type of cables. So, if you click here, this light thing sign here, connections, this is where you see all the cables that okay, this is where you see all the cables. So now you have so different many type of cables. And do you need to know, like, okay, what cable that you want to use? Do you need to remember that? Okay, now let me tell you one quick tips here. For networking, in fact, yeah, really there are so many cables. So what you really want to do is you just use the auto mode. So if you see here, do you see there is this thing called automatically connect? Now, this is very important, because let's say if I connect PC to switch using the wrong type of connections, it might not work. So let's say I do not know, okay, from this PC one to a switch, which are the cables? Should I be using this one or this one or this one or this one? It's hard to tell. So you use this one. This is God of Zeus. In Datacom, we pray to God of Zeus. With this lighting logo is Zeus, okay? And it will tell us the cable. Like you see, if I just click here and then I click left click here on the PC one, I click left click on the switch, it will give me one cable. So this is the automatic way to connect PC without needing to know what kind of cable. Actually, in fact, you see this is a straight line. So this one is actually a copper straight through cable. Copper straight through. Okay? And yeah, you don't need to remember, because every time you use auto mode, you can already see. For example, if I use auto mode here to here, then this is a straight through. Okay, I'm doing this, but I don't want you to do this yet. Okay, you don't do this yet. I will show you what you need to do. Let's say I have two routers, and I do not know what are the cables that I should use to connect them. So I will just use the auto and see, this is a dotted line. So I know from here, from this thing here, I have to use this cable, this dotted line, proper crossover. Okay, so this is how I find out. This is a quick tip that I think everyone should pick up. Like, how you know what are the type of right cables that you should use to connect different type of devices. Okay, so why I don't recommend directly submitting this network? This is because if you check on the completion, you already get some marks, but this is not the best way. Because when you use auto mode, they will automatically select the ports. If you remember, on the back of the switch, there are so many ports. You have port number 1, number 2, number 3, like something like this. Okay, let me just show this to you again. So yeah, let's talk about this. So even this thing here, you have so many ports. Now, sometimes you want to choose, I want to use this one or this one, the first, the second, the third. If you use an auto mode, you cannot, because it's already by default, they will choose one port. And in some case, you might not get the network correctly, because you see here, you need to make sure this PC is connected to FA01, PC2 is connected to FA02, PC3 is connected to FA03. Okay, so because of this, the auto mode you should only use to find out what is the cable type, but you should not use it to do all the work for you. Okay, I hope this is clear for everyone. So once you are clear, then we will do step 2 now. Okay, sorry Luis Tan, I think Luis Tan is angry because I make this not children friendly. Later I delete the part, I'm sorry. Okay, now come back to this. So you don't need the two routers, you only need this thing here. Now, based on what I have shown you earlier, and then you know, to connect PC to a switch, we are going to use a straight through. So I need all of you here to go to these cables, and then you choose this one here, click, and then you go using this cable, click on PC1, click on fast ethernet is the LAN cable port, ethernet port. Then you go here. Now this one is where you have to be careful. You have to follow instructions clearly. So for PC1, you want it to go to FA01. FA01 means Fast Ethernet 01. This one here. Okay, this one here. So yeah, this is done. This is definitely correct. Now I'm going to repeat the same thing for PC2. I click copper straight through. I left click on PC2. Click on fast Ethernet. Move to switch. And then based on the instruction, this has to go to FA02. So I click here. Then you will have the second connections done. Okay, now you should be doing this with me right now. Okay, so the third one here is PC3, FA to FA03. Yeah, this is the right one. Okay, so if you have connect these three PCs to a switch, you already have a LAN. Remember what we have just learned? This will give you a local area network. And now we are going to connect this switch to the router. So I take this copper cable, the same straight again, because this time I already find out that I'm supposed to use this cable to connect a switch to a router. So click here, read the instructions properly. You want FA04. So I will choose FA04. This is FA04. And then I'll go to routers. Now, again, routers, I have a few options. So which one should I go to? The instruction says FA00 on router 0. So FA00 is this one. Done. This is what you need to do. So if you have done step 1 and step 2 by now, if you check the result, okay, if you see I check the result, you should already get 4 out of 45, which means now all the hardware has been correctly configured and connected. You get all the right things you need. So the next thing onwards are on the software part where we will start to put in IP address for all of the machines. Okay, so by now you're supposed to have this. Then we go on to step 3. Alright, now step 3. So step 3 is assign IP. Again, remember, buy the hardware, connect the cable, then assign IP. Because we have learned this, if you want to communicate on a network, you definitely need an IP. Without IP, you cannot talk on any network. Okay, so this is how we configure. I will show you these three examples. I will finish the yellow color network, and then using the same theory, you will do this for light blue color and green color network on your own. Alright, so 3 PCs, so we need to do 3 times, we need to put in 3 IP address. Okay, now let's start with PC1. PC1, this is the IP which is already given in the instructions. So I just need to left click on PC1. It will bring up a box like this. So this is the PC, this is the real PC. You can see this is actually a real PC. I'm not sure whether it's 03 or 02 still see this, but yeah, this is a PC. Now you want to go to the desktop tab. At the top here, there are 4 buttons or 4 tabs. You want to go to this desktop tabs. And this is actually the desktop. Just like how you see your real desktop right now, this is the real desktop. So if this is a guy laptop, then you will see more icons here. Because guy never clean up desktop one. So just throw everything here. But this is a very clean desktop because it's a new PC. And these are all the programs that you can use. Okay? Now, next thing. You want to go to this IP config. Now, if you want to put in IP, this is IP config. Okay, so the first program here that we use, it will be IP config. Click here. And you will see there are 2 options, either DHCP or static. Now, so I want everyone here to be clear that when you give IP, in fact, there are 2 ways. The first way is static. Static means that we have to type the IP ourselves, which is what we'll do today. DHCP is automatic, means that we don't type the IP. The DHCP server or sometimes your router will give you an IP address, so we don't even have to think about what is the IP. Like right now, let me ask you a question. Like if you go back to any network or you go your house home network, okay, when you connect to Wi-Fi, what we do is we just take the phone and then we press connect to SSID. If there's a password, we put in the password. Then if it is the right password, we get to use the internet. We have never ever typed in IP address, right? Anybody here who type in IP address every time you want to connect to the network? I don't think so. Yeah, because right now it's all auto using DHCP. But now, because I want to show you everything from the start, I will teach you static IP first. So static IP is you type manually. So this is how you type. Based on the instructions, PC1 is 192.168.1.1. Okay, so I go to the IP here, I type 192.168.1.1. Now, the mask is 255.255.255.0. If you are lazy like me, you can always just copy and paste if you want. Oh, yeah, actually, in fact, you don't have to type the mask, it will automatically appear. So it's 255.255.255.0. Now, if you don't understand why this is the value, don't. This class, we don't want to talk about why this is the value. Next class, I will tell you. So right now, I only need you to type in the numbers correctly and properly. Okay, so you don't worry about what is a mask, why I type 255 three times. That one is for the next class. Okay, now, default gateway is your router. So in this case, it's 192.168.1.254. Why I type 254 is because it's already given here in the instructions. Your router in this yellow network will use 1.254. Okay, so if you have done this, just you don't have to click save or anything. Click this button to close this window, close this window. Now, if you check at the bottom right corner now, you should have more marks already, which means we are in the right track. Okay, we are on the right track. So we will repeat this for PC2 and PC3, the same thing. Because like I said, every PC needs an IP. So I go to the desktop tab, IP config, and I put in 192.168.1.2. The mask, okay, if you just do a left click, it will just automatically appear. So you can just skip this. And then type in the router IP, which is 1.254. Same thing. So it's supposed to get easier as you do. So yeah, this is 254, close this thing. And then again, you can see more marks. I'll repeat for 3. So 192.168.1.3, according to the instructions, PC3 will use 1.3. And then the mask is 255.255.255.0. You don't have to type that. And the last one is 192.168.1.254. This is your router IP address. Alright, so if you get all these three done, that means you're supposed to have 26 marks already. So if you do a check activity, you can see PC1, the IP is correct. It is connected. The subnet mask is correct. So I hope all of you here have something similar as what you see on the screen. You're supposed to have all the ticks for the first three PC, right? Until now. And then you should have 13 or 45 already. Okay? Now, if this is okay for you, then the last thing for this class, we are going to assign an IP for the routers. So to assign an IP here, click left click once, go inside here, and then you go to this second tab, which is called the config tab. Okay, it's a bit big. Yeah, so once you click on the config tab, you go and look for interface. Now in this, for this router, like I said earlier, if I look at the back of the router, so on the physical, I zoom in, this is exactly what you see earlier. Remember, it's look exactly just the cartoon version of the real router that we have just seen. Yeah, and remember what we just said, you can only build two networks. First network is here, second network is here. This is why when you click on config, you see you have fast Ethernet 0.0, fast Ethernet 0.1. So we only can build two networks with this router at this point of time. Alright? So what you want to do is you want to give an IP address for the router as well. So one interface, we call this interface or the port, will have their own IP address. So if the router can build two networks, if you have two interfaces, that means this router will have two IP address. If the router have four interface here, 1, 2, 3, 4, then the router have four IP address. How to have more IP address? Install more network card, then you have more IP address. Okay? So, yeah, if that is okay, then I'll show you how to put in IP. So again, from the instructions, the router IP address is 192.168.1.254. Now you have to be careful here because, as always, router can have many FA interface. So you want to make sure you put this into FA00 specifically. So you make sure you click the right one, okay? Don't click the wrong one. Make sure you choose FA00 here. And then you put it 192.168.1.254. This is the IP that is given in the instructions. The mask don't have to type. If you do a left click, you will see the mask is 255.255.255.0. Now that's not all. If you have done this, you will notice that this is still red color. Red color is not a good thing. It's only good during Chinese New Year, but red color is not good in packet tracer. It means that something is not working. Something is wrong. It could be a hardware, it could be a software. Something somewhere is wrong. So if all is green color, that is good. That is good. Okay? Now, it's still red right now, even though we have already put in an IP, that is because we have not turned this on. So remember this, there is one extra step in setting a routers. After you do all the settings correctly, you need to turn on, click this one to turn on. Okay, next time I will show you using a command, but right now we are using UI. So this is important. If you don't turn this on, it means that we are just doing the changes on the router, but we are not using or activating whatever that we have configured. So that is like a common mistake in most exams. Half of the student, I can say, okay, if I don't say this out loud, then half of the student during the lab test, they will lose the mark here because they forget to turn on. They do all these things correctly. Yeah, it's the hard part is done, but they didn't turn it on. So you have to really remember, don't forget to turn on. And if you have done so, this should go to green color. Okay, so if you are following me up until now, you should get a network. This is our first local area network. Give it a nice name so that you can remember them. And then yeah, PC123, connect to a switch, to a router. This is one LAN. Okay, they are all working already, all green color. So how do I know whether they work? Let me show you. In computer network, to know whether one device can talk to another device, we use the ping command. So ping is like you want to check whether there is a connectivity. Okay, so now I will show you the last example of today, which is to ping. So if I want to see whether PC1 right now is properly configured, and if it is able to talk to PC3. So let's use this as example, okay? So we want to know whether PC1 can talk to PC3. Now, to do this, you will need to use a ping command. So this is how I do it. Click on PC1, okay? This time you want to go to command prompt, the fourth programs that you have, command prompt. Now, over here, you type the ping command, and then you follow by the IP address of the destination. So let's take a step back and then think about what I'm saying here. So wait a minute, let me make the font to be a bit bigger. Okay, now it's bigger, so you can see. So ping again is used to detect whether there is a connection. Now in our example now, you want to do PC1 to PC3. So I will do the ping from PC1. The command I will type on PC1. The destination is PC3. I want to see whether this guy can talk to this guy. Okay, so this is the source. This is the destination. When we do ping, we go to the source PC. We type the ping command, but the IP here is the destination IP, where you want to try to ping to. And in this case, it is PC3. So we need to find out what is PC3 IP address. If you already forget, you can simply just click inside and then see this is PC3 IP. 192.168.1.3. Or if you feel like I'm a hacker, you don't want to use your mouse, you can always type ipconfig. And this is the IP for PC3. Now, I will put this IP in the ping command, 192.168.1.3. Remember, this is PC3 IP. Okay, so this is how the commands look like. Ping, followed by a space, and then the IP address of the destination. Okay, now if you press enter, two things are going to happen. If everything works, you will see a ping successful. But sometimes it might not work. So let's try. Press enter. And yay, we get a reply. So in this case, when you get a reply, it's definitely a good news. Means that PC1 can now talk to PC3. No problem. Okay, that's why you get a reply. Now I can show you an example where a ping failed. So let's say I ping to 1.4. And there is no one right now is having this IP 1.4. So naturally, it is going to fail. So you see, if I try to ping to an IP that nobody is using, you will get a request timeout. So when you try to ping, only two things will happen. Either this one, and then you can go and celebrate, or this one, and then you have to do overtime. Okay, so this is a ping command for you to know whether this guy can talk to this guy or not. So let's wrap this up with another example, last example of the day. I want to try whether PC2, okay? Let's do PC2. Can PC2 talk to PC1? So to do this, the source is now PC2, destination is PC1. So I go into PC2, I go to the command prompt, I type the ping command, followed by the IP of the destination host. So PC1 IP, what is this IP address? If you cannot remember, you can always come back here and check. So the IP is 1.1. So here, I will type 192.168.1.1. From PC2, try to ping to PC1, and I get a reply. Which means, yes, we can finish the class today right here, now because we already managed to build a network that works. Which means that everyone in the network can talk to each other. Okay, so if you are here, do a check result, you're supposed to get 15 out of 45, and if you finish the rest of the other two networks, then you will get all 45 out of 45. Okay, now, this is on the packet tracer side. Once you've done this, you can go back here, and then you can try to answer some questions. So I'm going to just do one example for you. And by the end, you see, maybe just 10 minutes after the class, somebody will already finish this. Okay, so let's try this. If you want, you have to answer this based on the network that you build. So you have to finish the whole network first. Otherwise, you will not be able to answer some of the questions here. But some questions, of course, is general, so you might not need the network. So for example, the first one, which type of IP addressing is used? So right now, it's called a private address, I think. Oh, it's wrong. Okay, let me try. Which type of IP addressing? This is a bit hard. I do not know what I said. Private IP. Oh, this is wrong. I mean, like, if you get it right, you get the marks. Yeah, static IP. Smart guy. I need coffee now. Yes, correct. You are so smart. Okay. I'm not sure whether I'm acting or not. So, yeah, you can do this, but you can see if some of the questions like this one is PC1 and PC4 in the same LAN. Now, without the network, you won't be able to answer. Okay, so you have to make sure you build the whole network first. See something like that, can PC1 ping PC4? Of course, you can just guess lah. If you are lazy, you can just guess yes, correct, or no. Okay, but if possible, if you have the time, because like we also don't have 1 hour class from week to week, so during that 1 hour, please don't say you don't have the time. Use the time to finish this Try Hack Me challenge, and I'll see you at the top here, okay? So guys, sorry I'm taking so long today for the extra 30 minutes, but I think it's necessary. because this is the first day you become a cableman. So after you finish this video, you are now a certified cableman. So what you need to do next is just go on, finish the network, make sure you have 100 of 100, and then go and try help me finish task 1 to task 4, and I'll see you on next week when we'll learn more about IP address, subnet mask, and IP addressing rules. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace out.